This is Dr. Pollock. Most physicians don't realize that fewer than half of the patients prescribed some of the most expensive drugs actually derived any benefit from them. This is according to Dr. Alan Roses, an academic geneticist from Duke University. The vast majority of drugs, more than 90%, only work 30 to 50% of the time. Drugs for Alzheimer's disease work in less than 1 in 3 patients, whereas those for cancer are only effective in 1/4 of the patients. Drugs for migraines, osteoporosis, and arthritis work in about 1/2 of the patients. Most drugs work in fewer than 1 in 2 patients, mainly because the recipients carry genes that interfere in some way with the medicine. People assume that because the medications their doctors prescribe are FDA approved, they will work and are safe for everyone. Studies done for FDA approval are often very limited in the number of people tested and only short term. There is no genetic profiling done in these studies. But because of the differences in people's genetics and interactions with other medications, food, or alcohol, more than 125,000 people die annually, and 2,700,000 people are hospitalized each year from adverse drug reactions. Even medications you have taken for years can put you at risk in the future. To work, a medication has to be properly metabolized, absorbed, and utilized. How you will respond to a medication is as unique as your fingerprints. Words like most or average don't necessarily apply to you. No matter the common side effects for any medications, and no matter the average statistics for encountering adverse drug reactions for a specific medication, you may still have a dangerous or life-threatening reaction. Until now, there was no way of knowing which medication would work best for which patient and at what dose. Personal, individual, precision genetics will determine if the medication will work at all, at a higher dose, at the normal dose, or if a much lower dose is best. Many physicians will recommend medications that have worked well for their other patients, not realizing that for a particular patient, the medication won't work at all. Only a test that looks at how your genetics affects a medicine, called pharmacogenetics, can forecast how you will be affected by hundreds of medications. With this test, you can know if a medicine will help you, do nothing for you, put you at higher than normal risk, or even kill you. The more medications you take, the greater the risk. Good news! Today there's a way you can find out if you are at risk from your medications. This is done by getting a simple pharmacogenomics or genetics test called PGX through a cheek swab. Much of the information for this video and blog is taken from the website parallelprofile.com that offers this test. We have no financial interest in this company, but believe in what they do. What I do want you to know is that medications can be vital in many circumstances and may not be able to be avoided. So if you have to rely on medications, at least be safe. I also know that PEMFs do not carry any of the genetic risks of medications. And based on my experience as an MD over 40 years, PEMFs are much safer, less potentially toxic, and can be as effective or even more effective than medications. In addition, PEMFs can frequently actually help to heal or strengthen the tissues that cause the health problems. Most medications only control but do not heal. With the appropriate PEMF device and appropriate selection and professional guidance, you will get the best result without the risk of harm or even death that can happen with medications. For more advice about appropriate PEMF selection, go to drpollock.com or contact us at info@drpollock.com or call us at 866-455-7688. Thank you for watching.